bless you, brothers and sisters and fellow warriors. I just learned from YouTube that I try to upload my latest video and I'm only limited to 15 minutes. So got to be really specific and kind of fast. to others, I did promise you that I was going to get these deliverance resources out sooner and I failed. So I try to be a man of my word. And to me, that's sin that I broke my word. So I ask for your forgiveness. So let's get right into it. The resources for deliverance. The number one question I get is, hey, you know, I don't have the resources or money to come see you or go to Texas, you know, or I'm in France or whatever. So I'm going to give you some worldwide resources that you can use. Anyways, first resources is OmegaManRadio.com. OmegaManRadio.com. This guy's a machine. He does like two radio shows a day. First part of his show, it's like a guest. Then the second part is he actually does live deliverances over the phone. So you can actually call in and have him start deliverance on you. He said that people have called in 5 times just to get deliverance. So he does get results. He has created another website called deliveranceregistry.com. And again, that's worldwide. It's not very big right now. It's kind of in its infancy, but I'd highly encourage you to go there to that registry first, and then before you go on to the next registry, I tell you. Omega Man Radio, I learned through him, and he works with another pastor, and they have a website called theministryofsalvation.org, theministryofsalvation.org, and they meet 3 times a day, maybe six or seven days a week. And they meet at 7 a.m., 9 a.m., and 8 p.m. Eastern. And you can call in or Skype in, and they'll actually do deliverance with you and pray with you during those church services. Now, the next website is called ministeringdeliverance.com. And I believe that it's the largest deliverance ministry directory out there. It was created by jbartlett.org. jbartlett.org. He is a spirit-filled Catholic, and so, you know, so you will get some Catholic persuasion. You know, I leave that up to you. Yes, I agree that some of the things, a lot of things the Catholics do are just not biblical. Some things they do is demonic. But the website, ministeringdeliverance.com, it's not strictly Catholic, so I don't know who you're going to get. So I highly encourage you to fill out their form, and I think someone's going to contact you within 2 weeks. Interview them. You know, once they contact you, you know, how do you cast out the demons? Do you deal with the legal rights of the demons? Do you care about my heart and why they're there in the first place? Or do you just want to come and push them out with power? You know, do you charge? And if they do, you know, it's up to you. You know, can you afford it? You know, do you want their services after talking with them? I highly encourage you to make local phone calls to your churches in your surrounding areas. There may be a local deliverance minister that God has already put in place. You just need to do maybe a little bit of legwork. I highly encourage you to find a local person. So, you know, if you're called to this ministry, then you can, you know, start a discipleship program with them. Ask them to sit in on those deliverances and start learning. You know, teach me things, you know. So those are the resources, OmegaManRadio.com. He did a DeliveranceRegistry.com, the Ministry of Salvation.org, three session a day. And down below, the first link I'm going to put up is actually Omega Man Radio and the pastor of the Ministry of Salvation.org actually doing a deliverance on the phone. So you can actually hear that on YouTube. And then ministeringdeliverance.com is a registry, world, you know, pretty big registry. And they also have a forum on that website, where you actually can go see that other people have specific ailments or demons that they're dealing with, or like other deliverance ministers, you know, ask questions, say, hey, I ran into this demon, whatever, and they answer questions. And then jbartlett.org, I think he has his own training too for deliverance ministers. I'm at 5 minutes, so I'm going to give you some examples of these deliverance ministers I've seen on the web and show you the different techniques that I use and why. Granted, you know, a lot of these people I'm showing you probably has more experience than I do. But, you know, you've come here for, the Holy Spirit led you here. So, you know, I feel like I'm responsible for you. I'm not bashing any of these deliverance ministers. You know, if they've cast out one demon, they're on the front line. So You know, I'm not going to go behind them and stab them in the back, but I do want to show you this is a teaching tool, and I would just want to show you the differences and how I would do things differently. And so when you're listening to Omega Man Radio or listening to these ministers on how they do their deliverance, you know, like Win Worley, you know, I'm going to show you just how I do things differently. All right, so here's the first example.
In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you demon out! 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 Fire! You demon out! In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Out! Out! What is going on?
Out! 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 You demon! Out! 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 In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
What is going on?
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out! Out!
Lindsay!
Out!
No!
Out!
No!
Out! Out! Tell me your name. You demon. You demon. I command you. Out. 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 You demon. Out. Holy Ghost fire. In Jesus' name, you are free.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus, you are free.
Amen.
Come on. Come
on. Oh my goodness.
Come on. Come on.
Oh my goodness.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
How do you feel?
I can't believe I have it in me.
You're free.
Sit down here. Sit down.
Out!
Free.
Out! Out!
Oh my God.
Out! 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 Holy Ghost fire! You feel fire, right?
I'm burning. I feel like I'm in a pit of hell. I swear, I'm really hot.
Yes! It's the fire of the Holy Spirit coming upon you. Fire!
I can't take it. I feel like I'm gonna explode.
Yeah.
I'm nauseous and I'm really hot. I'm really, really, really hot.
Holy Ghost fire!
I can't, I gotta sit down.
Fire! Holy Ghost fire! Holy Ghost fire!
John, Janine, you're
out! 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 Out!
It's coming.
Out! Out!
It's coming.
Out! 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 Naomi! Out! Fire! Fire!
I believe that God cares that you have demons and diseases, but I believe that He cares more about your heart condition. I believe full well that God uses demons for discipline. Look at Matthew 18. The king sent the unforgiving servant into prison and to the tormentors. Now, a lot of deliverance clients come and say, I think they believe that they just are tired of being tormented in prison. Well, yeah, I'm glad that you're tired of being tormented in prison, but now you need to serve the king. Now you need to forgive. Now you need to repent, confess, and do the things of what got you there in the first place. Now, I'm seeing a lot of deliverance ministers that, you know, like these guys weren't even dealing with the legal right at all. And that's the reason why I kind of want to use them as an example. If you're dealing with a demon that has legal right from God and you're trying to push it out by the authority of God, it can work. You know, we see that it works. But on the same token, it's putting the client through a lot of pain and suffering. a lot of pain and suffering, needlessly. And just so we're clear, my deliverances don't look like that. Okay? You're in a chair. Yeah, the demons might manifest. And when they leave, sometimes they leave through an organ and it might cause some pain. But, you know, I'm dealing with the legal right of why it's there in the first place. I don't encourage you to cough because coughing leads to gagging and gagging leads to throwing up. Unless you were a vampire and you actually drank blood or something like that, you know, or if it's like, you know, we're healing you of a blood disease or body poison, I don't believe you need to throw up to get rid of the demon. I mean, you didn't swallow anything to get the demon, right? So I think that's a fallacy that you know, people try to encourage them to cough and throw up. You know, I've never had anybody throw up in my sessions. Maybe spit a little bit, but, you know, we have a garbage can just in case. But again, that could be my infancy in the deliverance ministry. I'm not, like I said, I'm sure there's some special reasons why somebody needs to throw up, and that's fine. But that's not, you know, I want to deal with the legal rights of why they're there. If the demon says they have legal right, you know, who do we go to take away that legal right? Well, we confess it to God. And then once we confess your sins to God, then we bring that back the demon. They're like, yeah, I don't have any legal right. So I'm going to ask you, who gave that demon legal right? You know, so there's some things that I can't do. I know this might sound obvious, but if God's unwilling to do it for you, you know, if you're not willing to confess and repent and humble yourself, then what do you think I'm able to do for you? I don't have a magic wand. So I just want to point to these guys as an example that, you know, like the first guy, the big guy, when he goes on the ground, he just stops manifesting. Why is he free all of a sudden? Just because he stopped manifesting? I have a lot of times where the demons hide, where they just disappear. They go away. It doesn't mean that they're delivered. Question number two is, how do we know that how many demons were left? My experience, most people has like at least 20 different demons in them. Maybe he just dealt with one. You know, maybe the one just left, the one that was causing anger to the mom in the second example. So those are my questions, you know, and when you're listening to Omega Man Radio, they do get to legal right, but it seems like there's a lot of torment that they're causing the client and causing the demon before they even ask the question, hey, do you even have a legal right? And then let's just focus on one demon at a time, make sure it's gone, and then check. You know, oftentimes when I'm dealing with another demon, I'll be like, hey, where is demon such and such? Oh, he's in hell. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Yes. You know, so I'm constantly always checking, making sure, because there's been times I've cast out the same demon 10 times and he still pops back up. He just went away and hid, and he really does have a legal right. But, you know, and some demons have multiple legal rights. And so you think they're good and you cast them out and they've just been lying to you and they stay. So that's the difference. I really believe that God cares more about the heart than that you're being tormented. He wants you to come back. Like I showed you before, he uses everything in his power, including Babylon, including devil, including Pharaoh, including Judas, including, you know, thorn in the flesh, all this stuff for you to keep a good heart, for you to submit and humble yourself. And, you know, just because you're tired of being demonized, it doesn't mean that you're able to be free. You have to confess and break these curses. Or you go to one of these guys where they just push it out. And what stops a demon from coming back in? If you have an open door and legal right for these demons to come in, and they come in, they just push it out, and you go through a lot of pain and throwing up, and you know maybe they get rid of that one demon, what stops it from coming back in? There's one clip that I couldn't find. I saw it and I couldn't find, and they're spraying her in the face and tormenting a demon. And the demon said, yeah, I'll leave now, but I'm going to meet her in the parking lot. And my spirit told me the demon was telling the truth, you know. And obviously the guy's like, no, you're a liar, you know, get out. But you got to deal with the legal rights, guys. That's the difference. And if they have a legal right and I start pushing them out, you're going to see people vomiting. You're going to see people in pain. You know, it's not pretty. And so just deal with the legal rights. That's it. You know, that should be your number one question right behind what's your name. All right, God bless. I hate these new time limits, but God bless. Love you.